Dear friends, this is Prithivi Raj from Bangalore, sharing with you a few thoughts on subject Grace of God. Think about the role of parents who provide every good things and gifts to their children, to nurture them, to keep them comfortable. They continue doing so, though their children are rebellious at times. Why do they do so? Is it because of what they have received from the child? No. It is because of their nature to love them, provide them for their growth and prosperity. Similarly, God is gracious towards us because it is His nature to love and to do good. He is gracious towards us because He is our Creator. God, who is inherently, infinitely, and eternally gracious, provides for the needs of the humanity. Grace is getting what we do not deserve. Grace is God's unmerited favor and goodness towards us, who have no claim or reason to accept such favor. Grace is defined as the favor or kindness shown without regard to the worth or merit of the one who receives it. God is gracious from the beginning. Old Testament records several instances highlighting the gracious acts of God. In Genesis 6:8, we read as Noah found favor in the eyes of God. When Abraham and Sarah received Isaac, it was through the grace of God. Israelites were delivered from Egypt and established in the promised land purely by the grace of God. Although the grace of God was experienced by people in Old Testament, it is more explicitly expressed in New Testament. God revealed His grace through His Son Jesus Christ. Jesus was full of grace, and we received the grace of God through Jesus Christ. Idea of grace is more prominent in the Gospels, in the writings of Peter, John, and also in Epistle Hebrew. The word grace is used flexibly and in general sense. A doctrine of grace is more explained in Pauline epistles, where mankind is shown as sinner, but by the grace of God they are justified. God in His grace treats us as if we have never sinned, though guilty. Salvation is of divine origin, but God was not bound to save us. It is the result of His gracious will. We are saved. By His death and resurrection, Jesus Christ restored the broken relationship between God and His people. Therefore, salvation is only through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Every step in Christian living and growth is attained through the grace of God. Christian life is a demonstration of the grace of God. In Titus 2:11, we are told that the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives. In Ephesians 2:8-10, we read that by grace we have been saved, and we are God's workmanship created in Christ Jesus to do good works. We are expected to show the gracious nature through our daily acts, showing kindness and love. Our response to the grace of God has to be a lifetime response, that is, walking before Him humbly in loving obedience. Thank you for listening. God bless you.